So, now, which international institution had one man and his dog as members?
That was it?
Members. No, they had lots and lots of other members.
But they weren't men, presumably.
All the others were women and human.
The WI?
Yes, the WI.
Really? And Lassie.
The WI wasn't that particular man, by the way. This is an example, in case you're incredibly stupid,
of what a man and a dog look like.
Because you might not know.
He's literally blowing smoke up its arse.
The bloody dog move. Well, we'll have to use it. We're out of film.
When the WI was formed, the nascent WI, this particular man, Colonel Richard Stapleton Cotton, was an enormous fan, a great admirer, and so he and his dog Tinker were both members and paid their annual fees. But they were the only males ever to be members. Guess which country the WI was started in?
Canada.
Brazil. Yes!
Oh,
good God,
hell,
how'd you do that?
I don't know, I just know WI stuff, I don't
Canada,
know.
Canada, he said, in case you started in Canada, absolutely right. It was the Women's Department of the Farmers Institute of South Wentworth, with the aim to promote that knowledge of household science which shall lead to improvement in household architecture, with special attention to home sanitation. But then, of course, it broadened its horizons. It was said that the WI should be grave and gay. Which is nice.
Yeah, that sounds like me.
And should explore the world together and learn as much about growing roses in your garden or trimming hats as about darkest Africa or Bolshevism. So, which is why they're also famous for having lecturers coming to address them. They absorb knowledge, and they do an extraordinary amount of charity work, of course. They donate 24 million hours of their time to community work every year in the UK. And, of course, there's a double J association with the WI. It's our letter J. It's a sort of nickname for
Jam
it.
Jam and Jerusalem.
Jam and Jerusalem. Jerusalem is their anthem, and jam-making is what people think they do. But, obviously, their remit is wider, and they were very patriotic during the war, did all kinds of things, especially with rabbits. Turning bunnies into bombs was their slogan, as they tried to breed rabbits for food.
That picture that we saw earlier, I wish I'd been born in that time.
You like those dowdy hats?
I like those. I wouldn't have had to make any effort whatsoever. It looks great.
But everybody spoke like that. Everybody talked like that all the time.
Look at those berries. Amazing. They don't look very cheerful. And one of them's knitting, which is...
One-handed, which is really... There's Arthur Askey on the end.
They're voting. Shall we allow the Colonel and his dog to become members? And
yes,
all
go
voting,
on.
Yes.
Who's been felt up by the Colonel?
I have.
Dirty little bugger. That dog always sniffing around.
Oh, dear. Anyway, Colonel Stapleton Cotton was his name, and his dog, Tinker. They're the only two non-females ever to be admitted to the Women's Institute.